like Orion. I'm your host. I'm here this week, and I am between Terraminas.
You need a cough drop? We welcome you to Between Terraminas, of course, with Ian.
Of course, you're not Ian.
Yeah, whatever. And with Anthony.
Yeah. We just got breaking news, don't we?
Yeah.
We got breaking news.
Hang on, I'm hearing something through the earpiece here, guys. Something's coming on the wire.
Tayshaun Prince?
Something about Tayshaun
Prince?
All right, here we go. Reports say Pistons trade Tayshaun Prince.
They're acquiring Jose Calderon.
I question that deal. I don't know why.
You question it. Talk to me. Why do you question
it? It's not a good deal. I mean, like... Then again, you say $17 million, but...
Wait. Maggette's coming off the books next year. He'll be gone. Mm-hmm. That's $10
million. Yes.
You pick up Calderon's contract of $7 this year or whatever that's coming off the books. Goodbye. Tayshaun's going to be gone, right? Mm-hmm. Or wait. Either way, we're getting a lot of money here.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I guess.
What's the downfall of that?
Well, because you're losing your final piece of the 2004 NBA championship team.
Yeah, how many years ago was that? 9?
Yeah.
9? You got to move on. We got to get everybody out of here, man.
Including Tom Gores.
Tom Gores?
Don't you think he'll spend the money, too?
Karen Davidson's got to go, too.
She's not here anymore. She's gone. Tom Gores wants to spend. He wants a team.
Yeah, a team.
You guys don't seem happy about this.
A team that plays music during play. That's, you know, I'm not a fan.
It's horrible.
Is this why you guys don't want to talk Pistons? Because of the music?
No. Tom Gores, the Pistons are just not a good team right now.
The Pistons are actually doing pretty well right now for themselves. I mean, they've got some good wins against Boston and good win against Orlando. I mean,
sure, they've had good wins.
I mean, they're not that far off a playoff spot.
Which is sad because
the East is pretty bad.
They'd get smoked. The East is pretty bad.
Never.
It's all about the young bloods. We got a 22-year-old, a 20-year-old, and a 19-year-old.
I got to meet Andre Drummond. He's a really nice guy. Class act.
Let's build around
also
that.
Also trade Rodney Stuckey, too.
Goodbye, Rodney. Sure.
We'll see what happens.
All right. You know, hey, I'm excited. I'm excited.
Not.
Something might happen with the Pistons. Remember when they were rocking and rolling? It was great.
Who knows? I mean, we'll see what happens.
All right. Well, you guys are bandwagon fans is what you are. That's what's going on here. All right. Let's talk about bandwagon fans. Let's talk about the NFL. You're a bandwagon fan.
Yeah, and you're pointing.
I think it'll be a really good. It's an interesting matchup between San Francisco and Baltimore.
Sure.
I think that it's going to be a fun matchup. Super Bowl Sunday.
Yeah. Oh, it's going to be fun.
You know, you get to all those commercials. You get to see the
commercials. Good grief!
There's the passion.
Oh, just focus on the game. Don't worry about the commercials. You're spending about
close to four seconds.
$4 million for about 30 seconds. Are you kidding me? That is horrible. Horrible.
You're kidding.
Pretty bad.
Hey, too much money.
Who is their halftime entertainment this year?
Why are they going to do Beyonce?
I think her name is Beyonce.
Oh.
She would sing the presidential inauguration.
Yeah, she did.
She's gonna probably lip sing at the halftime show.
That is terrible.
That's what they all do,
that
man.
That is terrible. Roger Goodell should be ashamed of himself.
Oh, what about President Barack Obama?
Yeah, what about Obama?
President Barack Obama.
Oh, my
God. Who
was commissioner when Whitney Houston lip-synced the...
She didn't lip-sync, I don't think.
She did. The national anthem, she sure did. Hmm. Oh, you better believe it. They all do it, man. If you're focusing on that...
What about Michael Jackson in 1993?
Maybe not. Jackson?
Kid Rock
probably.
Does not
I don't
lip-sync.
Know about him,
you know
personally. Is that what you're most worried about? You're not worried about football? You're worried about Beyonce?
Well, if you look at the football thing here, it's like, you got to look at the matchup. It's a good matchup. Two good defenses. Two good offenses. Yeah. San Francisco runs the option attack.
Sure.
And it's just a good matchup.
Can we say probably the two most complete teams in the NFL this year?
Yes. No. I'm going to say
I'm
going to
say the Niners are definitely.
Niners are complete, yes. But the Ravens, I mean, I've said it before. I said it when they were playing the Patriots. It's going to come down to Joe Flacco. It's going to come down to that offense.
Yeah.
If the Ravens are going to win this game, then the offense has got to produce. The defense, yeah, the defense not as strong as past years.
Baltimore's complete. You see what they did to New England. New England had a young secondary. Their defense is horrible.
San Francisco's complete.
What about two teams
are both complete teams.
Okay, what has Flacco not done this playoff to prove to you that he can and he is stepping to the elite status this year?
Well, he's beating Tom Brady.
Peyton Manning and Andrew Luck.
Andrew Luck.
How many picks has he thrown this
Andrew
playoffs?
Andrew Luck's an elite quarterback? Eesh.
I said Flacco's on his way to being elite.
I think Flacco's going to win his... Oh, wait. Not
yet. You're leaning.
Maybe one day.
Who knows when?
Yep. You're leaning.
One day.
All right.
You're leaning. San Francisco. The thing is, the question is, you got San Francisco's pretty much got Colin Kaepernick, pretty much a freshman quarterback.
Yeah.
You got.
What's the problem with him? Has he not proven to you that he can handle it?
He's handled the pressure so far, but wait until next year when he gets his sophomore.
Hey, it's about one game right now. It's not about next year.
Randy Moss is talking how happy he's playing. And unlike somebody on the Lions.
You're happy Randy Moss is talking?
Yeah, about.
No human has ever said that, ever.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Randy Moss sucks and should never open his mouth. Best receiver ever.
What do you guys think about the Patriots not being here? Usually we'd be talking about the Patriots.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know.
Don't you?
You know, he could take that comment as a compliment.
Yeah,
usually we're talking about the Patriots because they're in every freaking Super Bowl.
Yeah, it seems like.
Anyways, we're not talking about the Patriots. Thank God. It's public access. You can say it.
Yeah.
Anyways. All right. Guys, we discussed the matchup a little bit. We both agree they're pretty complete. You don't. Yada, yada, yada. It's going to come down.
What's your pick for the Super Bowl?
What's my pick?
Who is your pick?
Who's my pick?
Yes, your pick. Who are you saying?
I'm going to take the little brother.
You're going to take the...
I'm taking Jim. I'm going with the man that punched Schwartz, and I'm going with the Niners.
I'm going to make my pick right now, and I'm going to tell it as it is. I think the Niners are going to win it. They have just a little bit more of a complete team than the Ravens.
I agree.
I think they're not as complete. They're not as complete, but I'll go with the Niners.
Okay, here's my pick. Drum roll, please! It'll be the Baltimore Ravens! Here's why the Baltimore Ravens is going to win.
You're covering the Ravens.
Oh, God. We've been hacked. We've been hacked.
Okay, let me finish my statement. You know,
is it time for a commercial break yet?
Yeah. I think the Ravens are going to win this game because of defense. Defense, defense, defense. Shut down the option, and they're going to win. And, of course, whoever said go Patriots on there, they lost to the Ravens! Get used to it!
What about Ray Lewis?
Oh,
what?
God.
What about Ray Lewis?
Time to make a phone call.
It's time for that. Time to make a phone call. Why?
Why?
What? What does that mean?
Trust me.
Why? Is Ray Lewis going to join Jerome Bettis in the analyst room next year?
Maybe.
Is he going to call you?
No.
Are you going to call him?
Maybe.
All right, how much time we got left? Are we close? I don't like your pick.
I do.
All right. Well, listen. Yeah, okay, listen. It's going to be the Niners.
Yeah, it's going to be Baltimore.
Yeah, it's going to be a good game, though. It's going to be a darn good Super Bowl.
Yeah.
I'm just calling that right now. All right, hey, when we come back, we're going to talk NHL hockey. Can you believe it? Right here on Between Terminus.
Prescription drug abuse is a national epidemic. The new in way to obtain drugs is through parents' or grandparents' medicine chests. Removing prescriptions from your cabinet is the best way to keep drugs out of the hands of our young people. We've got to work together to protect our teens, our seniors, and our environment. Clean out your medicine cabinet today. Please participate in Operation Medicine Cabinet and drop off your unwanted or expired prescriptions at one of our law enforcement drop-off sites in Oakland County. We can't ignore this situation anymore.
We own a habitat home.
I love working on my habitat home.
Soy dueño de una casa de habitat.
My neighbor is a habitat homeowner.
Being a habitat homeowner has changed our lives.
My mortgage payment for Habitat is less than what I paid for rent.
Habitat for Humanity of Oakland County currently has homes available with mortgage payments lower than most rent payments. If you or someone you know needs decent and affordable housing, call 248-338-1843. Or visit our website at habitatoakland.org.
Welcome back to Between Terminas here on Rory Neighborhood Television. Boys, hockey's back. Things are in the rightful order. The Red Wings are beating up on stupid teams that shouldn't be from Dallas, Texas.
You be quiet. That was a horrible... horrible game last night.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, your Dallas defense. Boy, this computer thing is really working out well today, isn't it?
What in the world are they doing here?
Yep.
What in the world is this? This is horrible.
That looks like a
this
bloody
This is nose. Horrible. This is horrible. I'll tell you what. You lose to Columbus last night, and then you lose to Detroit last night. I'm crying right now. I don't know what it is. They played a back-to-back night, you know, and Dallas didn't come into Detroit until the morning.
You know,
because of fog.
You know, that was a nice little monologue there, but did this show turn into
Dallas
Stars Manifesto? What the heck is this?
I was talking about last week, you were saying about how the Stars were going to beat Detroit and all that, and look what happened. That was a horrible, horrible game.
You got bragged about a lot.
Yeah, because if you look at it here, the Stars.
I don't even brag about it the way that you do.
Look at what the Stars. Of course, they don't have Derek Roy right now. You know, they're hurting right now. You know, I don't understand why Kari Lehtinen played in goal last night, but then he's But you know, there was one thing that Glenn Gulson, the coach of the Stars, said was, you know, at least we didn't get.
Will you shut up? This is not Dallas Stars review. Let's talk about hockey, huh? Hockey.
It is hockey.
Let's talk about the league. Let's talk about matchups. Let's talk about the shortened season. Let's talk about the injuries. Let's not talk about what GM Dallas Stars had to say.
What do you think about the West going against the West and the East going against the East all season? To be honest with you, we've talked about it before.
I think it stinks because I've seen Dallas twice in 1 week.
I think it's tough for the Wings because you look at the Wings got to go on a couple of those West Coast trips. And yeah. I think, aren't they the only team other than Columbus in the Eastern time zone?
Yes.
Nashville, too, aren't they?
Dallas Nashville's
the second most mileage that they have to travel this year. Minnesota's only is number one in that department.
Are you sure about that?
I'm not kidding.
Where are the Red Wings? You don't know?
I think they're four. They're number four.
Maybe. All right.
Well, I think that if you look at it, you know, I'm not a fan of the Wings, so I've been open about that, but at the same time, I got to give them props.
Do I want to say maybe March 26th?
Look at this, Patrick Waugh beating up Mike Vernon.
March 26th?
Look at it. That's a picture of Mike Waugh beating up.
You better check your facts there, Mike Waugh. I don't know about that. Whose hair's swinging because he just got clocked in the temple?
Patrick Waugh.
Yeah, Patrick Waugh's getting jacked.
Patrick Waugh's got longer hair, though.
Patrick Waugh. Oh, man, the Red Wings were that guy's Achilles heel, man. That was wonderful.
Patrick Waugh, the great. That's terrible.
Oh, my gosh, that's terrible.
Let's go, Red
Destroy
Wings.
Destroy that thing, please. Now. Oh. It's horrible.
Maybe we should turn this into Red Wings review here.
It should be Stars review.
You know, last night after the game, Jordan Tutu had a comment to say about Mickey York
last
from Fox Sports Detroit.
Oh, what a tutu!
This show is so far off the rails, I can't even breathe.
Wow, you gotta look at it.
You know, we're still alive, right?
Yeah. Hey, wow. Bronson's pack mule.
You know that, right?
Yeah, you love him.
I hate Yorn.
Look.
Me. Oh, look. I still cannot believe Latari's football had 2 goals last night.
I can't believe the show right now.
I know. He's lost control.
Filippula had 2 goals last night against my team.
Filippula. Valtteri. Filippula.
I have no idea what his name is. I still can't believe he killed my Stars last night. It was horrible.
Yeah, quiet, Steve Ott.
Well, I got to give credit to
Steve
where credit's
due. Steve Ott got traded.
Got to give credit.
Oh, who's Steve? Play for the Rangers now?
Sabres.
Oh, man. Yeah. Oh, the replays. Let's roll that Red Wings footage, shall we? Oh, yeah, a little giveaway somewhere behind the net, possibly.
What in the world?
Oh! Was this from the first matchup?
It's
from the first matchup.
This
looked like two Irishmen out at the bar.
It's from Fox News to Stars.
It's from there.
Ooh, ow. Ooh, ow. Man. Wow, he's giving it to him. Holy mackerel.
Jesus.
Wow, look at that. Wow. Oh, boy. Jeez.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, he kind of looks like Patrick Waugh with that hair.
No, it's
come
not.
On, boys. Let him go a minute more. Come on.
Well,
oh, wow. Tutu got his.
Well, just be honest here. I mean.
Yeah, that's a bad look for Jordan Tutu there. He's just wailing on his shoulder pads.
Just be honest here. I mean,
with
like.
What? The Dallas Stars suck?
Just be honest. Last night, you know, I'm going to be. It was just one game.
All right.
Just one game.
Sure. You know, this is a long fight.
I still think deep down, I think the Stars are still going to make the playoffs once Derek Roy comes back. They're still going to make the playoffs, even though they're 2-4 right now.
Oh, jeez.
But I still think they're going to make the playoffs.
You know, there are times where I really wish we were still at Oscars so I could have a drink.
Well,
some of the crap out of your mouth.
Let's look at this.
The
I mean,
Stars,
the Wings did get a nice statement win last night, I'll say that. They had a nice statement win against a very good Dallas Stars team. But, I mean, then the thing was they needed it. I mean, in many ways, you need all the wins you can get at
Dallas
this point.
Dallas was playing the back-to-back, though. Back-to-back.
They did beat Minnesota, too. That was a pretty good win.
It's a short season. There are going to be a lot of back-to-back games on every team.
Yeah, there is. I mean.
Sam, it happens.
The realization, Sam, to be honest with you, the realization is the Stars are just an old team. 40-year-old players?
Yeah. That's their big pickup? Ray Whitney? What? He was a rookie when my mom was born in 1966. Just kidding. All right. Anyways, man, I'm sorry. Am I hurting you too much today?
Yeah,
you lost a lot of
people
steam.
Been hurting me.
I'm sorry.
Night.
I can tell, man. Jeez, your shoulders are tense.
I'm not talking much
sorry,
about
buddy.
My abs here, and you know.
Everything. That's good. They're irrelevant too.
Well, you love the abs. I can tell. You look great in burgundy and blue. You look sexy in that.
Well, I look sexy in every color, but I'm not gonna be wearing that nonsense. Listen, any other news and notes you want to hit from the NHL here? Because I really have no idea how much time we have left. Okay, we got about 2 minutes. About 1 minute. We've got about one minute. That was a good question you had earlier. But, you know, that's something with the traveling and playing, you know, the East obviously has a big advantage.
Right.
What about the fact that every team is going to battle injuries? And do you
think
the playoffs are going to be – it might not be, you know, Chicago and Boston at the head of each or whatever, like it looks right now. It might be whoever's young and whoever can outlast, you know, whoever can have the least amount of injuries.
Right, that's true. Yeah. I think that's what it's about, you know.
You agree?
Let's see what happens.
So there's a shot for you, man.
Yeah.
You get healthy.
Get healthy. I think Stars will be fine.
You get your old man some oxygen, you know, every once in a while. You make sure he's tucked in at night and puts his teeth in the jar next to him.
No.
All right. I think we're set here on the NHL topic. Look, when we come back.
Call outs.
We're going to call people out right here on Between Terminas.
We want to have it at home.
I love working on my habitat home.
Soy dueño de una casa de hábitat.
My neighbor is a Habitat homeowner.
Being a Habitat homeowner has changed our lives.
My mortgage payment for Habitat is less than what I paid for rent.
Habitat for Humanity of Oakland County currently has homes available with mortgage payments lower than most rent payments. If you or someone you know needs decent and affordable housing, call 248-338-1843 or visit our website at habitatoakland.org.
Prescription drug abuse is a national epidemic. The new in way to obtain drugs is through parents' or grandparents' medicine chests. Removing prescriptions from your cabinet is the best way to keep drugs out of the hands of our young people. We've got to work together to protect our teens, our seniors, and our environment. Clean out your medicine cabinet today. Please participate in Operation Medicine Cabinet and drop off your unwanted or expired prescriptions at one of our law enforcement drop-off sites in Oakland County. We can't ignore this situation anymore.
Welcome back to Between Terminas.
Hi.
Okay. You're Ian and Anthony.
You just, oh, can I hold your hand?
No.
Can I give you a hug?
No.
Are you okay?
No! I'm not okay!
I know you're not okay.
I'm not okay!
Can we get some Kleenex on set here, please? Man, this poor man. I wish they would just move out of Dallas so this heartbreak can end. You're like a Lions fan. Just so hopeful every year, but just beat down because they suck.
You be quiet.
All right, let's do this. All right, what do we got? Call outs?
We got call outs.
Is that what's happening? I feel like the desk is going to fall off the stage here, but we're all set. Okay.
I'm going to do some texting a little bit.
You do a little texting?
Yeah.
Live on set?
Yep.
Can we pull that up on the monitor?
Mm-hmm. Doing some texting. You know, here's my call out this week. Got a hockey player out there, plays for the Muskegon Lumberjacks.
Okay.
His name? Kevin Albers, a.k.a. Mr. Ronnie Textall. Why? Simple. Look, man, I can appreciate what you're doing. I honestly respect it. I know you're trying to get in contact with your friends, but at the same time, can't text all the time, man. It hurts your thumbs, you know?
That's a good point.
Mr. Albers, at the same time, can't keep texting. It'll hurt your thumbs. Got to play hockey. Play it. Go on the ice.
You need your thumbs to touch a stick.
Mm-hmm. Is he texting on the bench?
No, not to my knowledge.
Rumors. He's been tweeting.
Oh, he's talking. He's chirping.
Yeah,
chirping. He's tweeting.
Gotta get off that iPhone, man. I'm just telling you. I'm just being a friend. Just being, you know. But Kevin, you want to respond to it? Let me know. My next call out involves a young man that has a history of listening to his father and his brother. Both of them have very strange sports views. Ryan Wood, why?
Oh, simple. Man, I can't handle this.
Oh, good.
That's my kid.
Why?
Simple. You get my kid off TV.
Nah. All right. Anyway.
Sorry, Ryan.
Let me do my call. All right. Why? Simple. Look, man, I know that you have a history of listening to your dad and your brother.
Yeah, he's a good child. He's a good kid. Maybe you should try listening to your father once in a while.
Cold.
You'd be a Wings fan.
Anyway, except your Lake Orion and Oakland views, which both of them do have. Their views are flawed. They're both of them. Ryan, you need to have your own sports views. You need to establish your own sports views. Do I think you can do it? Yes. You just got to listen. You got to listen to myself. Oh, I have good sports views.
Don't listen. Mute the television.
Ryan Wood? You're a good kid.
You just gotta keep going down the straight and narrow. Don't listen to him.
My last call out? My gosh. You know, we talk about Martin Luther King and I Have a Dream speech.
This one in this case,
he wrote an I Have a Dream speech because to have the most call out on between Terminus. Zach Green. Why?
Oh, dear.
It's not so simple. It's not simple. Why? Why do you want to get called out here? Call outs are usually bad for people. Zach, I don't get it.
Oh, man.
I don't understand it. All right, I'm done.
I make a motion to call you out every week. Both of us.
Well.
It has to be
my
done.
My call outs here, of course, I'm still hurt, but... You know, first one I'm gonna call Zach Green, okay? Zach Green, why? Let's look at it here.
Oh no.
I have a huge issue with this. You don't get none of that, I hear. You're always on Twitter saying to yourself that, where's your sleeping habits, buddy? Where is it? You don't have any?
Oh, good grief.
Are you kidding me? You need to be on sleep probation. I suggest you need to be on sleep probation. I don't know who that will do it for you, but you need to be on sleep probation. Because what I've been hearing rumors is you're always tired heading into class. I mean, like, and then you're always doing like this during school. I've heard rumors about it. I'm disappointed. Get some more sleep! Makes it easy on you. Get some more energy. More breakfast in school.
Oh, boy.
There you go. Breakfast of champions. And then my last call out, of course, I was in an open game on Saturday with Anthony.
They let you in there still?
Yes.
Yeah, I have.
Yeah,
and of course,
jeez.
We don't get the good seats, you know. But then here comes a guy who I think is walking. Oh, it's our supervisor, Chris Barnett.
Oh, no.
Chris Barnett, why? I see Chris Barnett walking.
He got himself a little pass,
then he got to sit at one of the nice seats.
With Dr. Rossi.
With Dr. Rossi, and I try to say hi. Do you respond? You don't respond! Why? Why am I dead to you?
This
Why am I dead to you?
You plaster his face on television.
I voted for you! And this is what the supervisor's supposed to be? You don't give me any highs? What have I done to you? Unbelievable. I'm disappointed. I'm sad. And you don't give me anything. I'm disappointed with you, Barnett. Why? Why? Why?
Why, you've been crying this whole time.
Oh my God. Oh my
goodness, you've been crying this whole time.
Do you think maybe the fact that you scream at him on local television and plaster his face up on people's walls every day, maybe why I didn't say hi to you?
No.
Do you think that has anything to do with it?
Nope. Nope.
I think it's got an awful lot to do with it.
Nope.
You call him out all the time, man. Jeez.
If he wants to come on the show, that's fine. I challenge him.
On other news, can I say something real quick? On other news, congratulations, Oakland University men's basketball coach Greg Campy. 500 wins. I'm very happy for you. I'm proud of you, coach.
I think now he can officially come on the show. He's a little bit more dignified now.
Well, he is
with
a,
500 wins,
he
we can
Clarkston,
take him.
He is a Clarkston fan because
that's
his
right.
son goes to Clarkston, so that's going to be very interesting.
Well, you're an Avs fan and you're a stupid Stars fan, so we let you on the show still.
Quiet.
But you know what this like red carpet's for, right?
But we're both Lake Orion nationalists, so that's a good thing.
Yeah, but you're—I don't know what you are. What? I don't know. You're crazy, deranged NHL fans. How about that? Avs and Stars.
Stars are going to make the playoffs. You just.
All right. All right. Whatever. Anything else you'd like to add? Anything else, boys?
Well, I mean, the whole Tayshaun Prince to, you know, the whole rumors with that.
Frankly,
I mean,
I'm happy. Quite pleased.
I think it'll be very interesting to see what happens going forward. I think we'll see what happens because, I mean, Prince was a good defender for the Pistons, especially with LeBron and Wade.
Back in 2004.
Reggie Miller's shot.
Yeah. Sure, yeah.
He's going to be remembered for that.
He will be remembered for that, but he's a role player. We can't hang on to him. If we were going to hang on to anybody, why don't we hang on to Chauncey?
That was one of the worst trades. Worst trades of all time.
That's one of the worst trades of all time.
Yeah. I mean, I was okay with them trading him if they traded Rip and Tayshaun and everybody else. Here we go. Reports still there for mm-hmm. those of you just joining us.
Yep.
These are the reports. Mm-hmm. You got your highlights on the side. You got a babe in glasses. Advertising for TurboTax. Get your taxes done, folks. All right, so hey, there's the news, there's ONTV, there's life in Lake Orion.
Yep.
And
have a great night, Lake Orion.
I apologize to the Lake Orion community.
No, that wasn't
for,
at
for
all.
Another round of Between Terminus.
Wow, you're cold, man.